All right. Where is coffee grown? Well, coffee is grown. I've drawn some lines on this sheet here. It's grown typically in the tropical climates, countries such as Panama, Costa Rica, Brazil, Colombia, and then in Africa, Ethiopia, Kenya, Uganda, excuse me, and a whole bunch of countries, Papua New Guinea, Indonesia, sparingly it is grown in other places, though not with too much success. Though there are, I have Googled recently that they are trying to grow some in the United States as well. It is out of my price range last time I checked. Different areas tend to have different general types of coffee flavors. So for a long time, I've been interested in Costa Rican coffees in particular. They're pretty mild and have a nice medium body that I like. Although lately I've been dealing or been brewing more Ethiopian coffees and going for the sweet fruit acidity type tastes that I've been really enjoying. Though I have had a number of Indonesian coffees and Sumatran coffees as well. So I highly encourage you to sample different flavors, different beans from all over the world. It'll be interesting to see what kind of beans you get with your popcorn popper when you get it from Sweet Maria's, because they come with beans from, and as far as I know, you never know what you're going to get. Top 10 coffee producing countries. Brazil, by far the largest coffee producer in the world, followed by a bunch of other countries. Again, sort of putting it together with the map, just so you have an idea of where coffee is being produced. And these are 2020 numbers. And these are tons and pounds. So units are important, as we will talk about. How is coffee grown and harvested? Well, this is a coffee farm, and on it you can see there are coffee trees. On each of those coffee trees, there are coffee cherries, and each of these is a coffee cherry. Within each of these, and you can see I got this from the Sweet Maria's site, after they've been on the tree 5 to 6 months, they're picked, and you get a coffee cherry like this. And each coffee cherry has two coffee beans or seeds in it. And the different parts that we're going to go over here, starting with the very outside, you have the exocarp. And the exocarp is the outer skin. Inside that, you're going to get the mesocarp. And that's often called the pulp or mucilage. Ledge, I think. Yep. And working our way inside now, more or less, we've got the endocarp right here. Oh, we forgot the pectin layer. Sorry. And then inside that, you've got the endocarp, which is associated with the parchment layer. And then inside that, you've got the epidermis, which is often called the silver skin. And keep going in. Now we've got the endosperm, which is really this whole seed or bean. So it's pointing to the middle here, but it's really this whole thing. And then that endosperm includes the embryonic layer. And here is the endosperm fold. And these are the formal names. They are definitely one of the homework questions about this and can be on your midterm. And then, but you'll find them talking not so much about mesocarp, but about pulp or mucilage that you're going to be stripping in some of the other videos and the different methods to do that.